All right, welcome back everybody. Plasticity today, we are going to make some geometric shapes. By default, plasticity only comes with three, a sphere, corner box, and a cylinder. So we're going to make some of these other ones here that doesn't come natively with the program. So we're going to start with the pyramid. That's about the easiest. You want to turn your snap on, snap to grid on. Go ahead and do corner box. We're going to select that origin line there. Tab. Want to make a perfect little cube. Okay. And keep your snap on there and make it a lot easier. Control 2 this top face so we select the edges and do a chamfer. Right click. Now we got a nice little pyramid shape. And all we got to do is extrude this bottom piece. Gone. And turn snap off now. And if you do scale V, click that center position there, you can adjust the height of your pyramid. So quick and easy pyramid there. All right, we got the simple one out of the way. Now we got the dodecahedron, which is a 12-sided. This one's not too hard to make. I'm going to go ahead and hide this one because I need that center origin there. And go to your polygon. Click on the origin and snap it. It doesn't matter how big it is. We just want that center point to help us out. All right. So now, and it defaults to the shape, to this pentagon shape, and that's what we need. If you do Shift D, we'll duplicate it. R, V to select an edge. And we'll rotate it down like that, and then there's a special angle you want to put in. So jot it down so it's 116.56505. Enter. There we go. Now we got our angle set perfectly. Do a radial ray around the origin again, and then just lower your instances to 5. Right click. There we go. We got the top half of it. Perfect. So we can already solidify it if we wanted. And I've got a hotkey set up for patch holes. So I just put my tilde key. So unfortunately, Plasticity right now does not patch multiple objects at the same time. So you have to just do it'll, but it will cycle through them. So if you, so patch, patch, patch. And I'm just going through and whoops, Control Z. Sometimes it does that. Select that one, patch. Okay, perfect. Select all of them, join. Now we need to Shift D, rotate. Need to rotate him 180 degrees, and then rotate another 180 degrees. Hate it when it does that. Yep, that's correct. And G, bring them down. Now let's merge our two points together here. So we'll go ahead, G, V. I'm going to select this little corner here. And hold down Control, snap them to that corner. Now we should be able to take both our halves and join. And now it's a solid object. There is our 12-sided. And let's go ahead. We'll just delete him. And we've got the 20-sided now. This one's a little more difficult. So what I use, what I found, is you can use this golden ratio or golden rectangles. And golden rectangle is basically a rectangle either 1.5 by 1 or 2 by 3. I think of it 2 by 3 is easier to remember. There's no point involved. So basically, they're all 2 by 3, and then you set it up into this orientation. Then all you have to do is do Shift A and start putting all the corners together. So you create all the individual sides. So you got to make 20 triangles there. So I'm not going to bore you with that. So I'm just going to do one that I already made. I'm going to turn off that there. You may run into the corners not lining up. You can always drag one out, hit control, hold down control, and realign it. But really, they are aligned. It's just a little. There's like 5 points over each point there, so it's kind of a display bug. So now we just do the same thing. We're going to select all these, and I'm just going to go through and start patching all my sides till I have all shells instead of curves. Now I should just be able to do J, and there you go. Obviously, that one is a lot more complex. So, but that is basically it. If you want to see another method of doing this, head over to Pixel Fondue. We both have the same idea on the same day, just different ways of doing it. So if you haven't checked out his channel, definitely check it out. If you want to learn more, even more stuff, come back over to my channel. I got a Plasticity 101 guide. Goes quickly through all the commands. And just keep on learning in Plasticity, and let's all have fun with it. And that's basically it for today, guys. It's pretty cool what you could do with this program. And we'll catch you in the next video.